Welcome back, folks. Dow Industrials are up 12, Nasdaq's up 80, S&P's are up 16.5. Let's go over to our man, Mr. Darryl Martin at Apex Investing. And of course, folks, this is going to be a big day out here this afternoon.
Forex market, there'll be some action in that market. Pound, maybe.
No doubt. Darryl Martin, what's going on, brother?
How you doing?
Doing great, man. Yourself?
Morning, Darryl.
Doing fantastic. Hey there, Tom. Tommy. So, yeah, we got some news coming out with the Brexit vote sometime today. There obviously is the expectation that they will reject it.
Right.
So, and then we'll see what happens next. What's y'all's expectation?
Well, in the currency trades here, so when we look at the currency trades, that's what I'm trying to figure out now, because the expectation Eastern time is that they claiming that they're going to start the vote at 2 o'clock, but they have four amendments first before they do the Brexit vote itself. And so they're speculating that it's a good hour to an hour and a half before they get to Brexit. So that's what I'm trying to figure out, is that these close at 3, huh?
Is that... Yes, I know. That don't make life any easier, does it?
No, that's important.
They did not
important. It's important
schedule.
For everyone to know, exactly. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah. Now, you do have the weeklies that you can put on, but of course, I mean, that can go a little crazy still. So it's nice to have some sort of hedge
good,
or low risk contract.
That's
on.
Better. That's better. Right. No, yeah. that'd make more sense because.
But if you want to be in it with defined risk, you know.
Right. Yeah. Because the last thing you want to do, folks, is be in the currency market when this thing gets released.
And we're getting some movement right now.
Without defined risk. I mean, that's what we're talking
about. These are 5-minute bars, and you can see the one that we're in right now sticking out. We're at the lows of the session almost going back, and since about 1 a.m., we're trading at 129.1.
And you're looking at the pound, right?
Yes, I'm looking at pound dollar. We're trading at 129.1. We're almost down a full penny. We're at 128.2.
Yeah.
And there hasn't been too much of a revelation since about 1 in the morning in terms of what they expect going on over there.
Right.
But I think the market's cluing in, and seeing some volatility coming at it, man. I'm sure it's going to have volatility in both directions come the news that breaks out.
Yeah.
The indices popped up a little this morning along with everything else, too.
Right?
Boy, they went quick, man. I mean, and
look at that NASDAQ just jumping over. 9:30, we're trading at 65.76. We trade up. Do we get a full 100? Not quite. 90 points, 1.5%, and a slight little pullback. Dow, I mean, look at the Dow. Dow erased all of the gains almost, which is pretty remarkable. I mean, we just went up to 20. We touched 24,000. Pretty remarkable. We're already down more than $100 from that level.
And, you know, folks, if you are looking at these indices, which is pretty cool, is that if you look at the Russell 2000, even when the S&Ps went up 24 points, the Russell 2000 didn't move. So that's telling you quite a bit. The Russell's been the weakest indice, but that was kind of shocking when I brought it up. It's like, oh, my God, what happened here?
We're actually at session lows right now in the Russell 2000 as opposed to NASDAQ.
Right.
100. It's just leaps and bounds.
It's been interesting how all the indices really have not, like, they've been way out of their correlation, you know.
Yes.
And you used to see them all rise and fall together, and that's just not been happening.
No.
I think that's a perfect illustration this morning.
I mean, no, it is.
Take a look at those three charts, whether it's the Russell, then you look at the NASDAQ, and then you look at the Dow.
Yeah. Because someone came in the NASDAQ, the NDX 100 in particular, and they bought the heck out of that when that whole thing went. And that just took everything right up. It was like right before we started the program, I went to Google, Amazon, and Netflix might have started it.
Yeah, I think it probably did.
Right. Yeah. Facebook is up $5.
I don't know about that one, right?
No, exactly. That's what I'm saying. That's what happened is that when I brought up Facebook, I says, okay, they bought them all.
They did.
You know what I mean? That's what's kind of, you know, that's the funds coming in straight across saying, okay, man, I'm going to hit the NDX 100. I'm going for it.
And we're getting some negative action in that pound as they pull back up. I mean, Darryl, since you almost came on with us, man, we've gone from 128.3 down to 128. Nothing.
That used to be like a 1-week move right there.
That's what I'm doing. I mean, yeah. And even sticking out on this, those bars stick out, which is remarkable considering we just moved a full penny. But big bars, and I wonder what's going on over there. Maybe there's some news breaking out of there, right?
Yeah.
That's people back too. So.
What's that, Darryl?
He's about 50% retraced from his run up this morning.
Okay. Yeah, it's amazing.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, the moves we got, both directions.
I mean, this is a lot better volatility we had yesterday. Yesterday was just blah. So.
It was. We kind of hung out for most of the afternoon at a pretty similar.
Yeah, and you know, it's gonna be intriguing, especially us being on the outside looking in, because it seemed that when you look at the analysis over there, they're going to vote down Brexit in a huge way, but yet they're not going to get Theresa May out of the government, because what they're talking about is that people in her own party are voting against the Brexit, but they're not going to vote her out.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah, no idea. Yeah, yeah.
So it's like, okay, so what are you going to do then?
I saw an interview today of somebody exactly saying, you know, that they support May and they're going to vote against it.
I know.
The question was, well, how do you support her if you're going to vote against her plan? And, and I think I just stopped listening at that point because.
Yeah, totally.
You know, so that creates constant uncertainty, which is good for us with all the.
And it's true because that's crazy, right? You know, you obviously don't support that person. That's obviously why there's problems.
No,
if you're electing a leader that you don't support, that's going to cause problems, especially in something so difficult because it is quite a task on her plate to get it done, especially when you're dealing with support. That's
And you know, it's probably underlying they just don't want to leave because underlying, if remember, May was against it. But she said they voted for it, so she'll make sure it happens.
Right.
Do you know what I mean? And so that could be the same thing with a lot of other people that,
it's so contentious, it's tough. You know, it is. And the bottom line, though, is that they voted for it, man. And, you know, they should be getting it done. They want to vote for it again, that's great. But in the meantime, that's what they voted for. So votes have consequences, as we've said. And it's not right. I mean, you know, whether you believe in it or not, you want votes to have consequences.
Because
someday you're going to be on the side of the votes or something.
Right.
And if they don't do it, that's how government falls apart. So
there's no doubt, man.
Yeah.
There's no doubt.
Yeah.
You know, last time we were on, Darryl, we were talking about the touch brackets, right?
Yep.
So how are those going?
They're going great.
Okay.
So
they're
keeping the liquidity there. You can hop in. They refill it. Hopefully there's some more market makers coming on here in the next couple of weeks that'll add even more liquidity and, of course, tighter bid-offer spreads.
Yep.
And I was just going to pull.
I mean, it's get in and out of them easy.
Sorry, jumping in again, but they're forex. I mean, they have pound dollar, they have euro dollar, and then, of course, they have the indices as well in there. So you have forex, and you have them. I know, pretty cool, right, in terms of.
The touch brackets today would be pretty cool.
Except for the 3 o'clock.
Except for the 3 o'clock, I know.
And the similar deal, that the touch brackets are expiring at 3 o'clock.
Wow.
No, they won't expire at 3. They'll just stop trading at 3. They'll actually stay open. Like, so you'll be able to, if you're in, you'll still be in when the market reopens. Because they go to Friday.
Oh, interesting.
Ah,
that's right, because they're weeklies, right? Okay.
Perfect. I just looked at the 3, but time left 3 days. Oh, okay. Wow. So that's even more interesting. So So, how does that work, Darryl? At 3 o'clock, they stop trading until when?
Till 6.
Till 6.
Eastern. Get
your popcorn out, man. Sit back and watch the chart while you're kind of hanging.
You know, it's funny, man. That's almost like you can almost do a volatility trade in this, maybe. That's going to be interesting, man, because that pound is going to move around all night, I suspect. You know.
Well, here's what's really interesting about them too is it's based on the indicative index. Okay.
Yeah.
So the indicative, from what I understand, doesn't move between 3 and 6. So there could be some insane volatility in there.
Yes.
And then it opens back up. And, you know, hey, if it's past one of your walls, then it expires at, you know, the floor of the ceiling. But if it's not, you have to surf that volatility and it could come back down and be in your favor when it opens back
up. Yeah, it's just going to smack
it's
open
tricky.
Up.
It's tricky. It's just like the option market.
I'll watch it. I'm going to watch
it myself
today just to get a feel for it. That'd be a good time, right?
That'd
be the best time, right?
Right, best time.
Darryl, thanks so much, man. You have a great one, a safe one.
All right, you too.
Thanks, Darryl.
Stay right there, folks. Tommy and I are coming right back. We have the Dow 10, Nasdaq's up 73, S&P's are up 15. We'll come right back.